Merry Christmas, everyone. I know with the pandemic, things have been a bit bleak. But today is Christmas and it is time to celebrate. I know there is a lot of woe in the world, but today is a day of light. And like the Whos of Whoville, who woke with all the usual Christmas finery gone, they still found that light of Christmas cheer and went outside and happily sang in welcome of Christmas Day. So if, after you listen to my reading, you feel the light of Christmas, I ask you to stand outside your front door and sing for Christmas. It doesn't have to be the Who song. It can be any Christmas song that puts a smile on your face. You don't have to be a great singer, and you can mumble the lyrics if need be. Just call out to the world that Christmas is in your grasp as long as you have a way to clasp it. Merry Christmas to you all, and remember the true meaning of Christmas is not in things. It is in love. Now I am proud to present my Christmas present to all of you. William Pattison, Christmas 2020, The COVID Pandemic.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel. You're a monster, Mr. Grinch. Your heart's an empty hole. Your brain is full of spiders. You've got garlic in your soul, Mr. Grinch. I wouldn't touch you with a 39 and a half foot pole. You're a vile one, Mr. Grinch. You have termites in your smile. You have all the tender sweetness of a seasick crocodile, Mr. Grinch. Given the choice between the two of you, I'd take the seasick crocodile. You're a foul one, Mr. Grinch. You're a nasty, wasty skunk. Your heart is full of unwashed socks. Your soul is full of gunk, Mr. Grinch. The three words that best describe you are as follows, and I quote, stink, stank, stunk. You're a rotter, Mr. Grinch. You're the king of sinful sots. Your heart's a dead tomato splotched with moldy purple spots, Mr. Grinch. Your soul is an appalling dump heap, overflowing with the most disgraceful assortment of deplorable rubbish imaginable, mangled up in tangled up knots. You nauseate me, Mr. Grinch, with a nauseous super nos. You're a crooked jerky jockey and you drive a crooked hoss, Mr. Grinch. You're a three-decker sauerkraut and toadstool sandwich with arsenic sauce.
How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss. Narrated by William Pattison. Every Who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot. But the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season. Now please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be his head wasn't screwed on just right. It could be, perhaps, his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small. Whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos, staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at the warm, lighted windows below in their town. For he knew every Who down in Whoville beneath was busy now hanging a mistletoe wreath. "And they're hanging their stockings," he snarled with a sneer. "Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here." Then he growled with his grinchy fingers nervously drumming. "I must find some way to stop Christmas from coming." For tomorrow he knew all the Who girls and boys would wake up bright and early. They'd rush for their toys. And then, oh, the noise. Oh, the noise. Noise, noise, noise. That's one thing he hated. The noise. Noise, noise, noise. Then the Whos, young and old, would sit down for a feast. And they'd feast. And they'd feast. And they'd feast. Feast, feast, feast. They would feast on Who pudding and rare Who roast beast, which was something the Grinch couldn't stand in the least. And then they'd do something he liked the least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing. They'd stand hand in hand, and the Whos would start singing. They'd sing, and they'd sing, and they'd sing. Sing, sing, sing. And the more the Grinch thought of this Who Christmasing, the more Grinch thought, "I must stop this thing." The more the Grinch thought, "I must stop this whole thing. Why, for 53 years I've put up with it now. I must stop this Christmas from coming. But how?" Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. "I know how to do it," the Grinch laughed in his throat. And he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. And he chuckled and clucked. "What a great Grinchy trick. With this coat and this hat, I look just like Saint Nick. All I need is a reindeer." The Grinch looked around, but since reindeer are scarce, there was none to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said, "If I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead." Then he called his dog Max. Then he took some red thread, and he tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sleigh, and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, "Giddy up!" And the sleigh started down toward the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. All their windows were dark, quiet snow filled the air. All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came to the first little house on the square. "This is stop one," the old Grinchy Claws hissed. And he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pinch. But if Santa Claus could do it, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once, for a moment or two. Then he stuck his head out of the fireplace flue, where the little Who stockings all hung in a row. "These stockings," he grinned, "are the first things to go." Then he slithered and slunked, with a smile most unpleasant, around the whole room, and he took every present. Pop guns and bicycles, roller skates and drums, checkerboards, tricycles, popcorn and plums. And he stuffed them in bags. Then the Grinch, very nimbly, stuffed all the bags one by one up the chimney. Then he slunk to the icebox. He took the Who's feast. He took the Who pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out the icebox as quick as a flash. Why, the Grinch even took their last can of Who hash. Then he stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. "And now," grinned the Grinch, "I will stuff up the tree." And the Grinch grabbed the tree and he started to shove. But then he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast and he saw a small Who. Little Cindy Lou Who, who was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny Who daughter, who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said,
"Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?"
But you know that old Grinch was so smart and so slick. He thought up a lie, and he thought it up quick.
"Why, my sweet little tot," the fake Santa Claus lied, "there's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there, and I'll bring it back here." And his fib fooled the child. Then he patted her head, and he got her a drink and sent her to bed. And when Cindy Lou Who went to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. Then the last thing he took was a log from their fire. Then he went up the chimney himself, the old liar. On their walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire, and the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Who's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Who's mouses. It was a quarter past dawn. All the Who's still abed,
all the Who's still a snooze when he packed up his sled. Packed it up with their presents, the ribbons, the wrappings, the tags, and the tinsel, the trimmings, the trappings. 3,000 feet up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the top to dump it. Poo-poo to the Who's, he was grimishingly humming. They're all finding out that no Christmas is coming. They're just waking up. I know just what they'll do. Their mouths will hang open a minute or two. Then the Who's down in Whoville will all cry, boo-hoo! That's a noise, grinned the Grinch, that I simply must hear. So he paused, and the Grinch put his hand to his ear. And he did hear a sound rise over the snow. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, the sound sounded merry. It couldn't be so. But it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville. The Grinch popped his eyes. Then he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presence at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or another, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light, and he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he, himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast. Welcome, Christmas. Bring your cheer. Cheer to all Who's, far and near. Christmas Day is in our grasp, as long as we have hands to clasp. Christmas Day will always be, just as long as we have we. Welcome, Christmas, while we stand, heart to heart and hand in hand. Merry Christmas to all. How the Grinch Stole Christmas by Dr. Seuss. Narrated by William Pattison. Sound design by William Pattison. A Wolfpack Presents production. Copyright 2020. Welcome.
cheer. Fa, who, fa, res, da, who, do, res. Welcome all who's far and near. Welcome Christmas, fa, hoora, moose.
Welcome Christmas, da, who, da, moose.
Christmas Day will always be just so long as we have we. Fa, who, for, res, da, who, do, res. Welcome Christmas, bring your light.
Ooh.